Hello, Lamb fans. Unexpected video. I had a package in the post, and if you're regular to the channel, you'll recognize where it's come from by this. Roll side. It's Captain Ray Pauls. Mrs. Ray Paul. Thank you very much. Well, they sent me a couple of things that I noticed. The first thing that caught my attention, I've got the acoustic guitar, you may have spotted. It's been put into open G tuning. Lovely. And the reason being, Captain Ray Paul made and sent me this. Look at this. A brass slide. Made to what it turns out to be the perfect specifications. Haven't measured it. Not going to measure it because it's good. Could get the calipers on it, I suppose. But Captain Ray Paul knows the measurements. It was about 50, 60 mil long. 24 mil roughly, is it? 1.5 mil wall. Anyway. The important thing is, look at that, you wanted to see, specifically Captain Ray Pauls, to see how it works. This is how it works. The nice thing is, it's got a bit of heft to it, but because it's a smooth steel surface, it essentially acts as a fret, because obviously your frets are smooth, rounded surfaces, so is this. So you stick it on the old finger there. Now, different people have lots of different techniques. My technique is the appalling, never done this before technique, but basically, it can get on the finger there. Look at that, it fits perfectly. And then this little finger I also use to secure it, sort of, you know, so it sits in between that. And then with your open G tunings, I apologize for knocking the mic, I haven't got a lot of space. I didn't prepare, but so it works. It's cool, isn't it? And all the other nods as you do it. So thank you very much for that. It turns out it's perfect. That's all I'm going to do because I'm not really got any good slides until now, so I've never practiced. So it's just a bit of open G shenanigans, but you know, very good. Thank you very much. The other thing I noticed here, which I haven't looked at, is on the back here, it has it says try this pick. So let's put this down and let's try this pick. Let's open the pick together. So here we go. Try this pick. Yeah, I think I've seen a picture of this, so I know we've got an idea of what's coming. Sorry, I've had to rip through the roll tide. That's okay. I'm sure there'll be more. What a cool little package this is to get. There it is. Oh, now I have to tell you. That's cool. Aluminium pick. Look at that. Nicely rounded, perfect shape. What I was surprised by the obviously it's aluminium, it's light. With the thickness. We must try this. Let's put a guitar on. I want to specifically try with an electric guitar for a reason. Right, let's try it. So I've got a sound. Already I can tell it's definitely a different sound. Hang on, let me turn that up a bit. Let's turn some of the effects off. It's just the straight guitar sound there. Well, I've also got what I normally play is like these sort of celluloid picks. This type, you know, this sort of celluloidal plastic. We've also got the lamb picks, of course, but they're a bit of a thick pick. Similar material. We're waiting for the proper ones. But I am going to be posting these out to the people that have asked for them. But here, there is a noticeable difference, and let's see if I can emphasize the difference here. Here's the plasticky pick. Let's get a sound. And then here's the metally one. It's spikier. Mm-hmm. if I try and do that with the plastic one, it'll sound quite... And the reason is, it's the same as the slide, believe it or not. Because it's a metal surface, the string can resonate against that surface, whereas the plastic surface will sort of, it's softer, it takes the energy out of the impact. So what I can do is I can sort of scrape the metal pick across the string as I pick. So the difference is between being able to do that. This isn't about playing, by the way, this is about the sound. And if I get the metal one in there, look at that. You can hear that. I can almost scrape it. That's the reason Brian May plays with a sixpence. You can hear all that cool little scratchiness. And that, I mean, if I concentrate, I can get rid of it. Almost. But that's the difference. You get a lot more pick attack because the whole pick is exciting the string, and it's really cool. The other thing you can probably do is some quite cool effects with the edge of the pick. Because again, if I use the edge of this, it actually wears a notch into it. Not really nice noises, but this one, because it's metal, you should be able to, yeah, you hear that? And I know that doesn't sound like much, but if you listen to the first Pink Floyd album, Sid Barrett used to do that, and when you do add back in the effects and things of a, like, you get a cooler which is cool. It's cool. I'm just having fun. Now I'm going to play a solo with it, or part of a solo. Let's pick up a song. That's enough of that nonsense. So there you go. Look at that. So it's a cool aluminium pickety pick pick. Very cool slidey slide slide. Brass slide. All courtesy of Captain Ray Paul. Look at that. Roll Tide. Peace. Lamb out.